This part in red is particularly alarming. Notification of the subject about the obtainment of information regarding their use of Bitcoin may be detrimental to the seizure of any Bitcoin balance. They're going to attempt to seize the Bitcoins. Therefore, we are going to search family, friends, bank tellers, Facebook, Twitter, social media outlets, subpoenas to every application you've ever downloaded. And it really is at the whim of the government. Hi guys, my name is Colin and this is Colin Talks Crypto. Bitcoin was created 10 years ago as a stance against the status quo. It was a stance against governments having too much power over us, especially when it comes to our money. It was created in response to the housing crisis and the misappropriation of money that the government and the Federal Reserve doled out in response to that. It's a stance against abuse of freedom of mankind, and Bitcoin is an enabler of personal freedom for individuals around the globe. As such, it should probably not come as a surprise to you that the IRS and other high-level bodies are very interested in cryptocurrency and abuses using cryptocurrency, especially when it comes to criminal affairs. In this episode, we're going to take a look at how far are they willing to go to uncover and seize Bitcoin assets. So I came across this very interesting tweet. This is from CryptoTaxGirl, and I will put this information on the screen so you guys can see this as well and follow along. And she said, "I recently got hold of a presentation given to special agents in the IRS Criminal Investigation Division that discussed investigating taxpayers who hold crypto. I went through all of the 181 horribly formatted slides attached here for reference, and here's what I learned." So first of all, big thank you to CryptoTaxGirl for making this public information. I have no idea how she came across these slides, and I also cannot verify the authenticity of these slides. I'm just merely passing along what I found that she somehow got a hold of. Second, I want to point out that she is a tax consultant. And I did note that she keeps referring to, like I just said, taxpayers who hold crypto. And I don't know that that's actually true. To me, it seems like this is more of a target against criminal misuse of Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies. However, if you did not pay your taxes, you would then become a criminal in the IRS's eyes, and therefore you probably would be subject to such searches. But I just wanted to note the spin on these tweets that it's about taxpayers when it's really more about criminal offenses. So I'll first read her tweets and then we'll go into something very interesting on this and a specific page from this document that's very alarming. "The IRS plans to use interviews, open source searches, electronic surveillance, social media searches, and grand jury subpoenas given to a variety of companies. You would think that these subpoenas would be served to crypto exchanges, but the IRS plans on serving them to Apple, Google, and Microsoft in order to search through taxpayers' download history to see if they have ever downloaded cryptocurrency applications." Another slide mentions that the agents should be sure not to notify the taxpayer, again, she's using the word taxpayer there, more like criminal, about the obtainment of information regarding their use of Bitcoin, because such notification could be detrimental to the investigation. So they're not going to notify you if they're searching about you. "The IRS also plans on serving subpoenas to collect bank, credit card, and PayPal records. These records should be analyzed to determine if any payments in or out went to parties that can send or receive crypto. The IRS also plans to review Facebook, Twitter, and other social media platforms to find publicly available BTC and Ethereum addresses. There's a ton of other information in there about crypto in general, tracing transactions via the blockchain, limitations of blockchain, etc. But what you need to know is that the IRS is working hard to identify criminal cases involving cryptocurrency. I pray that none of you reading this gets audited, but after going through those slides, it wouldn't surprise me if some of you do." And at the very end, she says, "If you reported everything correctly already, though, you have nothing to worry about." So again, this is if you're committing crimes using cryptocurrency, you're going to get looked into in this manner. And if you've paid your taxes and you filed properly, you should have nothing to worry about. So just to cast the FUD aside on this. So now let's get into the document. This document is 181 pages long. I'm going to put the link in the description below. This is the link that she provided, and I'll put a redundant backup source just in case. And the document's entitled Internal Revenue Service Cybercrimes by James Daniels. It's horribly formatted and it's very ugly. It looks like it's written in the 1990s, but nonetheless, the information is what's the important part here. So the TLDR, the too long didn't read, of the sections covered in this gigantic document is: what is virtual currency? Cryptocurrency goes over the top 14 cryptocurrencies, including detailed information on Bitcoin, Ripple, Bitcoin Cash, Litecoin, Stellar, and Monero. It covers smart contracts, ICO issues, ICO failures, Bitcoin mining, blockchain, different kinds of forks, exchanges and what opening an account consists of, Bitcoin kiosks, Bitcoin wallets and keys, hardware wallets, paper wallets, Tumbling and mixing Bitcoins, tax implications of Bitcoin, dark web, deep web, how Tor works, and ransomware. And lastly, and the part we're going to dive into here, is it covers getting information on users. And this was shocking to me, and it opened my eyes as to what level the government and IRS is truly willing to go to uncover information about you. It says, the determination of whether or not a subject transacts in or maintains a balance of Bitcoins can be accomplished by several methods, such as interviews, open source searches, and electronic surveillance. However, one method that should be considered is serving grand jury subpoenas to a variety of companies. Issuance of a grand jury subpoena should be considered for Apple, Google, and Microsoft for the subject's complete application download history. Each application's function should be explored to determine whether or not the application can transmit or otherwise allow transactions in Bitcoin. And they will perform searches on people such as those who know the financial habits of the subject, including, but not limited to, bank tellers, family, and friends of that subject, if feasible, and establishments the subject frequents that may accept Bitcoins, Facebook, Twitter, and other social media outlets. So if you're out there in any form, even in your personal life, your friends, your family, your banker, or online, Twitter, Facebook, etc., YouTube, and you're performing criminal activities, they're going to search for you in all these avenues. This part in red is particularly alarming. Notification of the subject about the obtainment of information regarding their use of Bitcoin may be detrimental to the seizure of any Bitcoin balance. They're going to attempt to seize the Bitcoins. Several companies offer services in which a user can back up their Bitcoin wallet online so that a secure backup with a third party of all of the user's Bitcoin addresses and private keys exists so that they can try to extract them. So again, this is for a criminal use case, right? So if you're an honest citizen and you're a law-abiding and you're a taxpayer, you should be totally fine. However, I think that this is important because there is always a false flag, a false positive, or what if you're just someone the government doesn't like and they want an excuse to come after you? They could say, well, we have reason to believe that this person, such and such, is a threat. Therefore, we are going to search every single thing I just mentioned: family, friends, bank tellers, Facebook, Twitter, social media outlets, subpoenas to every application you've ever downloaded. And it really is at the whim of the government. So yes, it is for criminals, and those are probably the prime suspects, but who's to say what arbitrary decision the government decides is a criminal? And historically, we've seen this abused in the past. The IRS could target any person it wishes, really with any reason it wants. So this is why I feel it's good for you to know this information, just to know at what extent they're willing to search for. And you wouldn't have a clue that they're searching because they're not going to tell you if they are searching on you. So like any law or legislation, its intents seem good on the surface. Yes, it's for criminal intent, but it's when it becomes misused and put toward ordinary people that it becomes abused. And that has happened historically, and that is the problem with governments overreaching and overstepping their bounds. And so I wanted to bring this to your attention. I think the moral of the story is do not get on the criminal side of things. Do not use crypto for anything criminal. Do not use US dollars for anything criminal, for that matter, so that even if they come after you, even if they decide to search into you extensively, exhaustively like this, they won't find anything because you have nothing to hide. But I thought that was a real shocker. Hope you guys learned something from this. Let me know what your opinions on this. Is this uncalled for? Is it okay because its intent is for a criminal use case? Or do you feel that this could be abused in the future? Let me know your opinions in the comment section below. Please like, please share, and please subscribe this video. Get the word out of what our government is willing to do in these circumstances. Thank you very much and have a great day. Talk to you again soon.